trans murder that started a movement. When Rita Hester was murdered 17 years ago, the LGBT community promised not to let her die in vain. As reported at thedailybeast.com, Rita Hester was murdered 2 days before her 35th birthday. On the evening of November 28, 1998, police found the African-American transgender woman in her apartment stabbed in the chest, a staggering 20 times. She's somehow still alive, but died from cardiac arrest as soon as she arrived in the hospital. For transgender community in Boston, it was the sun had gone out. A remarkable individual put forth as today, so we're observing color and change, and 25 individuals have been laid to rest this year due to transgender discrimination, and we represent equality for equity at large, and you know, this color, this representation, oh yes, she, he, queer nation, you can be straight, you can be gay, you can be bisexual, you can be representing the colors for her, the fight against misogyny, and the misogyny is the unrepresented hate for women based on no apparent reason. So today we're representing a gay plus tau, and you know, January 20th represents the year since inauguration, and we represent, well, why is this so important in our military? Why is it so apparent for our future? As Rita, renowned and infamous Reverend Irene, sorry, Rita was renowned and infamous Reverend Irene Monroe, a speaker at the 1998 legal for Hester, told the Daily Beast. Everybody knew her, especially in the trans community and the African-American LGBT communities. Monroe recalled that Hester's mother, Caitlin, took a microphone at Beagle and said in a flattering voice, "I would have gladly died for you. Rita, I would have taken the stabs and told you to run. I love you." The procession began at the Model Cafe in Alliston and ended outside Hester's apartment building, where Kathleen and her children kneeled together and recited the Lord's Prayer. There were tons of tears, Monroe says, but also anger, and the fear of recent rash of transgender killers in the area would claim more lives. The fear was justified. So as we put forth advocacy and differentiations of change, the jurors let their homophobia, their transphobia, get the better of them. Man Gironi told the Phoenix of the Palmer verdict, "I feel they did not do their job, and frankly, I hope this keeps them awake at night." And Man Gironi since called a chillingly ironic response to the verdict. Hester herself once provided a comment on trial at a local LGBTQ newspaper, "I'm afraid of what will happen if Palmer gets off lightly. It'll give people a message it's okay to do this. This message we cannot afford to send." So commentating on this message we cannot afford to send, what message are we sending when we digress and put forth advocacy and representation for individualism to come at large? And I know this season we're really celebrating some fine plays across America, such as Kinky Boots. Kinky Boots was a historically renowned play based on the leather representation of a transgender individual who saved a man one night after a bar brawl, and she put forth advocacy to rebuild his establishment and corporate entrepreneurship as a leading role model progressing shoes and outerwear for transvestites, transsexuals, and individuals at large. And I know one winter I met one mighty fierce individual who I will not name, but you know who you are, Miss Red Queen of before. From Little Miss, you know the system of why you're at the door. From Bahama, the motion of why you be, it's plants with beauty in this Oshi. We represent her cardly, proudly today. And I say cardly because you cannot put the card of a queen from before. We want defiance, and this is the more. Rita Hester, we march for you 20 more, and we come back to serve the message, and this is our store. So my name is Eugene Nicholas Emilio Santos, making a proud advocacy to make change in my life for addictions at large that serve back the meaning of Sarge. We can be found at 59 Chestnut Street, to the local corners of U for gender equity and U plus 2, for the colors of red for honey delight. It's like the glance of Y, Dijon, the bite. And yes, she can be a France plus 2, and we represent Javier Medina, the sounds of this interview. And this is a representation from the Queen of Justice Moore. We are proudly the representation of York's back door. Just for a day, we can save a life. And here's 22 push-ups against the knife. Thank you.
Thank you.